Long and gracious God, we thank you that we can call you that, for you are our loving and gracious God, and full of mercy and hope, full of restoration. Lord, we thank you for hearing all of our prayers, both spoken and unspoken. We pray that you would do what you do so very well, and that you would be involved with humanity, that your will be done in our own. We know that you have a whole plan all worked out, Lord, so Lord, we trust you with your plan, for you know everything before it happens, because you've already planned out, you've already been there before us. So Lord, we just thank you that you are faithful. We thank you that you are loving. We thank you that you are merciful. We thank you that you are creator, sustainer. Lord, we thank you for the Holy Spirit that you've put within each and every one of us. And when we don't have those words to pray, Lord, we can't articulate it. We just can't say it. Our spirit, our soul cries out to you. And we thank you that you understand this language. But most of all, God, we just thank you for your Son, for you coming here and showing us how to do what to do, and then taking on our sins so that we can be redeemed, so we can be restored to you, dying for our sins, but you rose again on the third day, and you conquered sin and death for us. And we thank you for the example of our risen Lord Jesus Christ, when the followers of Jesus Christ, his disciples, when they asked him, Lord, teach us to pray. Well, he said, well, when you pray, you need to pray as this. Our Father, whom art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Amen.